It is a relationship of long standing and of great importance, not just because we have a very strong economic relationship, but because we have watched and seen the rise of China as it has grown, as it has lifted millions and millions of people out of poverty. And that rise has contributed to the strength and the growth of the Indo-Pacific as well. But with that growth and with that development into a strong and significant power comes, in our view, a degree of responsibility in how one exercises that power. Australia will always engage constructively with China, but we will always, always consider the advancement of our national interests in doing so. And any sovereign nation would take the same approach. What we have seen in recent times has certainly presented challenges in the relationship, because we have considered that some of those actions have threatened Australia's national interests. And there are a number of actions which were enumerated publicly by diplomats in Canberra that were provided to media by the Chinese embassy in Canberra, where no country would actually agree to change their approach. Countries which respect a free and open media would not agree to restrict that. Countries which respect the independence of institutions like think tanks and universities would not agree to restrict those. Countries which, in protecting their own national interests, protect their own security in cyberspace and in other areas would not agree to do that.